reverse control grip. Arm drag. So off the shoulder. Basically, you're isolating the wrist, grab the back of the tricep, pull them across, step it forward. These are just little subtle things you can do to set up your leg attack. Another thing off hand fighting that we're doing. Tuck under. So basically, especially when someone's reaching up high like this, you always want to break at the elbow. This is where you kind of control their arms, wherever they bend. So you can control somebody at the wrist, control somebody at the elbow, and then later, control somebody at the shoulder. Tuck under, that's what it looks like. Some subtle things are staying close to the body. Less distance you have, obviously, it's harder for Matt to respond. A lot of times people do a duck under like that, he pulls his arm down, it's still right in front of you. But it depends how the... I get caught like that all the time, but it just depends how the flow of the match is going. Where his body lands. Yeah, similar was a thing. Thingy. Heard somebody call it a shuck. And it's that same elbow move. Turn. So here you're going to pass that elbow like a duck under. It's right here. The person has to be moving into you a little bit at least. And their arm's got to be a little bit straight. That's what the collar tie buried in my chest right here. This is going to make it difficult. So that's not what I'm doing. But as soon as I pop his elbow, grab back my neck. You're going to see him loose and kind of grip. There, right? That's all it is. Right at the elbow, breaking the elbow. It's a thingy. And then there's also a pinch. This is from kind of hand fighting. Pinch. Lean into arm, forearm, back of the tricep, surface step. Right. They don't always go to the back.